Welcome friends, Pooja here from domainracer.com. In a previous video, I have told you about how to do staff management setting. And if you missed that, then in the description of this video, I have given the link so you can see from there. And in this video, I am going to cover how to do the payment gateway. So in the setup section and in the payments, select a payment gateway. Here I am using a PayPal payment and I already signed up for this. Next is the all payment gateway. Here you can click on the payment gateway to activate and begin to use this. And if the payment gateway is not listed here, then you can contact your payment gateway provider. They will provide you WHMCS module. And in my case, I am using PayPal, so I already choose this. Then next option have a manage existing gateways. Here first is a display name. Enter the name as I am using a PayPal. Next is a PayPal email ID. Enter your PayPal email ID. So my PayPal email ID is sales@dedicatedcore.com. And these four options keep as it is. But if you want to change this, then you can. Then here you have to enter your API username, password and the signature. So in my PayPal account, I have already logged in. Now in a tools section, come to the all tools. Now scroll down and choose the API credentials. Again scroll down and here it is view API signature. Now to view the API username, password, signature, click on the show buttons so that here you can put these all value, username, password and the signature. So here I have already pressed my username, password and the signature. And if you are setting this payment gateway for the testing purpose, then select this box and save the changes. So our changes are successfully saved, and in this way you can set up your payment gateway. Now next I will show you how to add the currencies. So in the setup section and in payment, click on currencies. From here you can add the currencies. You can see the our base currency is USD, and suppose new currency I want to add is Euro. And the prefix will be this and the suffix is just EUR. And here is the format. You can choose any of the format. So with this currency code and the prefix and suffix, it will display like this. That means this is our prefix, this is the value and this is our suffix. And here is a base conversion rate. So our base currency is USD and the base conversion rate is 1. So let's check if we convert from USD to Euro, then what will be the base conversion rate. So you can see that is a 0.84 base conversion rate. So enter here and click on add currency. So here you can see our new currency, and in this way you can add the currencies. Now next is tax rules. From here you can configure the tax rule. If you want to enable the tax rule, then tick here. Then you can choose the tax type, that may be exclusive or the inclusive, and apply tax to. Here you can choose the particular product to which you want to apply the tax. By default it is a domain, late fees. I'll uncheck the late fees and select this custom invoice. Then having a compound tax. If you want to charge the compound tax, then also that is possible. Just click over here. And in the next you can see that level 1 rule, level 2 rule. And from here you can add a new tax rule also. Here you can choose the level 1 or level 2. I'll choose 1. Here enter the name of the tax rule. Suppose that is India. Then here you can choose the rule for all country or for a specific country. So I'll choose only for the India. Choose the India here. Then here you can choose the state also. That means if you want to apply the tax rule for a specific state, then that is also possible. But I'll apply this rule for all states. So currently in India, the GST is applied on each and every product, and that is 18%. So I'll also put as a 18% tax rate. And lastly, click on add rule so that your tax rule will be added successfully. And if you want to add tax rule for the level 2, then similarly you can do this and save the changes. So as you can see, our changes are successfully saved, and in this way you can set up your payment. And in the next video, I will show you how to add the servers.
Press the bell icon on YouTube app and never miss another update.